He stated ontogeny repeats phylogeny. So ontogeny means life history of an individual, or we can say that the development of its own, खुद का डेवलपमेंट, लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल और द लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ अवर ओन इज कॉल्ड इज ऑन्टोजेनी, एंड फाइलोजेनी इवोल्यूशनरी और एंसेस्ट्रल हिस्ट्री. फाइलोजेनी मीन्स इवोल्यूशनरी और एंसेस्ट्रल हिस्ट्री. So ontogeny repeats phylogeny means when an organism is developing, jab bhi koi organism when it is in its growing age, jab wo uski growing age mein hota hai, then it repeats the ancestral history. Uske khud ke development mein it repeats its ancestral history. For example, when we have studied about the early development in the triploblastic animals, though it was we or the human beings that are also following the same type when we talk about the early development in the vertebrates, though the human beings were having the same kind of development the human beings were also developed from the same type, that they were also having the gill slits in their early development, they were also having the tail, and they were also having the same type of development of the ear and earbuds and the eyes. So this, when they are developing, jab ek human being ka khud ka development ho raha hai, at that time it is also following its phylogeny, it is also following its evolutionary history. इवोल्यूशन के टाइम पे या पुराने टाइम पे वो कैसे एक के बाद एक इवॉल्व होकर हायर इवॉल्व ऑर्गेनिज्म बने, तो एट द टाइम ऑफ इट्स ओन डेवलपमेंट और एट द टाइम ऑफ इट्स द इंडिविजुअल डेवलपमेंट दे आर फॉलोइंग द एंसेस्ट्रल हिस्ट्री ऑल्सो. दिस वॉज अबाउट द ontogeny repeats phylogeny, that the ancestral history is being followed while the development of its own. Ancestral history khud ke development ke time par follow hoti hai to show the course of evolution. This was the ontogeny repeats phylogeny, and we have completed our fourth type of evidence, that is embryological evidences, in the category of, which was the category of evidences of evolution. The last which we are going to take is biochemical, physiological and cytological evidences. The last category of the evidences of the evolution that we are going to take is biochemical, physiological and cytological evidences. There are like we have seen in the embryological evidences, this, that there is the similarity between the lower groups also and in the higher group also. Like that, in this category also there is the similarity in the lower category of the animals and the higher category of the animals, that is they share the common type of biochemical processes or the common type of metabolic processes, common type of physiological reactions, etc. The first example we will take is of the enzymes. trypsin. It is a proteolytic enzyme and amylase. Trypsin and amylase, these both are present from sponges to mammals. The enzymes like trypsin and amylase, these are present from the sponges, which is belonging to the phylum Porifera, and to the mammals, which are belonging to the phylum Chordata. Porifera, the very lower, the organism which is belonging to the very lower phylum, and the mammals, which are very highly developed organisms, the both these trypsin and amylase work as the same. This is the proteolytic enzyme. It will act as a proteolytic enzyme in the sponges also, and it will act as a proteolytic enzyme in the mammals also. And the same work will also of the amylase. It will also work the same in the sponges as in the mammals. And due to this reason, they are called as universal enzymes. Universal enzymes, trypsin and amylase. It is obvious to call them universal enzymes because they are present from the sponges to the mammals. They are having the same type of functions. So this shows that the sponges, which are very lower category of the animals, and mammals, which are highly evolved animals, they have been evolved from the same type of, they have been evolving by following the same types of evolutionary pathways. Or the mammals have been evolved from these lower type of organisms, and by evolution and further development, they become the highly evolved animals. The second example is of hormones. Hormones are also alike in nature and function. These are also similar in the nature and function in many of the organisms, or in the many of the classes of the organisms. When we talk about the hormone, thyroid hormone. Thyroid hormone, it is the very important hormone of our body. It helps in the growth and development, and it helps in metamorphosis, in frog. So thyroid, or the tyrosine hormone, which have been released from the thyroid, it's helpful in the growth and development in our body, and metamorphosis in the frog. So if this thyroid organ has been removed from the frog, from the tadpole, agar thyroid ko tadpole se, tadpole ki body se remove kar diya jaye, then it will stop the metamorphosis. Uski body mein metamorphosis nahi hoga, because for the metamorphosis, the hormone that is needed, that is absent. And when we artificially inject, agar hum artificially inject karenge thyroid hormone ko to the body of that same tadpole, then it will start the metamorphosis. Chahe wo thyroid hormone ह्यूमन बींग्स में से क्यों ना लिया गया हो, या फिर वो थायराइड ऑर्गन ह्यूमन बींग्स का क्यों नहीं हो, इफ दैट हैज बीन इंजेक्टेड इनटू द बॉडी ऑफ द टैटपोल, देन दैट टैटपोल विल स्टार्ट द मेटामॉर्फोसिस एंड इट विल गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू द फ्रॉग. सो दिस शोज दैट एम्फीबियंस में मेटामॉर्फोसिस में हेल्प कर रहा है, एंड इट इज ऑल्सो हेल्पफुल इन द ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट इन अवर बॉडी. It is performing the same function हियर ऑल्सो फॉर द ग्रोथ एंड हियर ऑल्सो फॉर द ग्रोथ. तो दोनों ऑर्गेनिजम्स में एंड दे आर बिलोंगिंग टू द सेम फाइलम. तो दोनों ऑर्गेनिजम्स में वन इज स्मॉलर टाइप ऑफ और वन इज लेस इवॉल्व्ड टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड ह्यूमन बींग्स विच आर मोर इवॉल्व्ड टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स द सेम हॉर्मोन इज डूइंग द सेम टाइप ऑफ function. So this is also the clue for the evolution of the man, that the higher evolved animals have been evolved from the lower category of the animals. The third example we will take is blood and lymph. Blood and lymph, they perform the same function. They are having the same type of function in all the other animals, that blood is a kind of connective tissue. ये connective tissue है. अगर हमारी body में ये connective tissue है तो दूसरे animals की body में भी ये connective tissue ही होगा. And it is also performing the same type of function as it is performing the function in our body. Both of this blood and lymph are having the same type of constituents also, like as in our body. So this is also the clue for the development or for the evolution of the higher type of animals. The next example is blood proteins. Blood protein, it is also called as hematin. Blood proteins, hematin. So the work on blood proteins shows that the human beings, these are more closer to the apes and to the chimpanzees rather than that of the monkeys. Blood proteins ki study se hume ye pata chala ki human beings are more closer, human beings jo hai wo zyada closer hai to that of the apes and to the chimpanzees rather than that of the monkeys. Monkeys are the far ancestors of the human beings. This shows, the study on the blood proteins shows this. Fifth, one more thing in the blood proteins, that our blood protein matches to the chimpanzees and apes, and blood protein of human beings similar to the apes and chimpanzees, and the same type of blood protein or the same blood protein is also present in cows, goats and sheep. These three organisms or these category of the organisms also share the same type of blood proteins, and the cat and dogs, these also share the same type of blood proteins. Next example we will take is of blood group. We know that blood group are present in the form of ABs, A, B and AB. The A and B system of the blood group is present in human beings, apes and chimpanzee, but they are absent in monkeys. So this also shows that human beings are close to the apes and chimpanzees rather than that of the monkeys. Sixth, cytochrome. This we are taking from the cytological evidences. cytochrome. It is present in both plants and animals. In plants, cytochrome is used for photosynthesis, and in animals, cytochrome is used in respiration. In ETC, we can say that electron transport chain. In the animals, the cytochrome is used. So, the cytochrome is being used in the plants as well as in the animals. So, this shows that the plant and animals have been evolved from the same type of ancestor, that is Euglena. We have already discussed that the Euglena is the connecting link between the plant and the animals. So, the presence of the cytochrome in both plants and the animals shows that these plants and animals have been evolved from the same kind of ancestor, that is Euglena. The seventh example is about excretory waste. Fishes and tadpoles. Fishes and tadpoles, they excrete ammonia. They are ammonotelic type of organisms. And frog, which is the adult form of that tadpole, it is ureotelic. Fishes and tadpole are ammonotelic, and frog is ureotelic. So, both of these organisms, this shows an example of the convergent evolution. Convergent evolution, that fishes and tadpole and the frog, both of these are belonging from the different environment. Fishes and tadpole, these are aquatic, or we can say that these are fishes and tadpole, they are different categories of the animals. Fishes are purely aquatic and tadpole is the organism from the amphibian class. So, though they are belonging to the different class or from the different environmental conditions, they are excreting the same kind of excretory material, that is ammonia. This is an example of the convergent evolution. And the organelles, the eighth example is about the cell organelles. Cell organelles like mitochondria, and chloroplast, and many other cell organisms these are also similar in many of the, in all the types of the cell, whether it is a eukaryotic cell which is highly developed or the eukaryotic cell from the less developed organism. They, all the cells are having the same type of cell organisms. All are having same type of cell organelles. So, from all these examples or from all these evidences, it shows that the higher evolved animals have been evolved from the their lower evolved or not so evolved animals. Jo sabse zyada evolved animals hai, wo unse kam evolved animals hai, ya fir unke ancestors jo ki kam evolved the, unhi se itne zyada evolve hue hai. All these categories shows, these are the evidences of the evolution. So, here we have completed our the topic evidences of evolution, in which we have studied about the five categories First was morphological and anatomical evidences. Second was paleontological evidences, in which we have studied about the different types of the fossils and how the fossils are being studied, and different kind of the methods for the study of the fossils, and various examples about the Archaeopteryx and the missing links. And we have also studied about the evolutionary part of the evolutionary history of that horse, of the phylogeny of the horse. And in the morphological and anatomical evidences, we have studied about the different types of organs, homologous organs, analogous organs, vestigial organs, and the connecting link and the atavism or the reversion. The third category under the evidences of evolution, which we have studied, was the biogeographical evidences. In that, we have also taken the three examples. First was Darwin finches, the second discontinuous distribution, and the last one restricted distribution. The fourth was that embryological evidences. In that, we have studied about the similar type of early development in the triploblast, similar type of early development in the vertebrates also, and the theory which was put forward by the Von Baer, the recapitulation theory, which was later modified by the scientist Ernest Haeckel, and he modified that recapitulation theory into biogenetic law. And the fifth and the last evidence which we have studied was the biochemical, cytological and physiological evidences. Under this, we have studied all these examples, the similar type of enzymes which are present in the lower animals, or which are present in the non-chordates. The same type of enzymes are also present in the chordates and the highly evolved animals, that is mammals. The similar type of hormones are present in many of the animals, and the blood and lymph, which are present in all the organisms. The similar type of blood is present, and the similar type of function is performed by the blood and lymph. They are also having the same type of chemical combination, or the same type of composition having this in all the animals. The fourth example we have taken is blood proteins. By the study of this blood protein, we know that the men or the human beings are the close in relation with the apes and chimpanzees rather than that of the monkeys. And the blood these blood groups also shows that human beings are close to the apes and chimpanzees, because AB type of blood group is not present in the monkeys. The sixth is cytochrome, which shows that plants and animals have been evolved from the same type of organism, that is Euglena. The seven, which we have taken, is excretory waste, which gives us the example of, which is also the example of convergent evolution. And the eight, the cell organelles, that all the organelles of the cell are similar. In all the cells, the same type of cell organelles are present. Here we have completed the second topic from the evolution, the evidences of the evolution. Later on, we will discuss about the theories of the evolution.